seven men for an association. If possible, of peers and baronets. They start off with a public declaration. To what extent they mean to pay their debts, that's called their capital. If they are wary, they will not quote it out to some immense. The figures in material, it may vary from 18 million down to 18 pence. I should put it rather low. The good sense in doing so will be evident at once to any debtor when it's left to you to say what amount you mean to pay. Why, the lower you can put it at, the better.
When it's left for you to say what amount you mean to pay, why, the lower you can put it at, the better.
They then proceed to trade with all who trust them, quite irrespective of the capital. It's shady, but it's sanctified by custom. Bank, railway, loan, or Panama Canal. You can't embark on trading too tremendous. It's strictly fair and based on common sense. If you succeed, your profits are stupendous. And if you fail, up goes your 18 pence. Make the money spin a spin, for you only stand to win. And you'll never with dishonesty be twitted, for nobody can know to a million or so to what extent your capital's committed.
For nobody can know to a million or so to what extent your capital's committed.
If you come to grief and creditors are craving for nothing that is planned by mortal head, certain in this veil of sorrow, saving that one's liability is limited. You suppose it signifies perdition, if so you're but a monetary dance. You merely file a winding up petition and start another company at once. You may be in your own capacity as a company, you've come to utter sorrow. But the liquidators say, never mind, you needn't pay. So you start another company tomorrow.